So I put one pile, but I left. So you notice Buddy kind of hogged it because Ransom won't win. So I'm gonna go over here and stand by him. Come on, Ransom. Come on, it's okay. You behave. It's okay, come on. So as long as I'm here to keep the peace, they'll eat. So I normally don't feed them in one pile unless I can stay out here. It's just easier to put two piles and let them eat, but I would like it to where I didn't have to be here to keep the peace. So the wind is really bad out here, and I'm trying to cover the phone, but Buddy, I'm gonna knock you off. If he pushes him again, I'm gonna push him off. Better because Buddy won't push over me. He's more apt to push when I'm away from him than over me. Watch this if I go over. So now I'm gonna stand between them and there's less problems. So, I mean, it's kind of odd to try and figure this out sometimes because it's not like they're competing or they're starving. Little Ransom's getting his little long fur in. He's gonna get really hairy. They both got their butts to the wind. So see, when I'm here, it's like, no big deal. They share nicely and it's not a fight. It's amazing when you get a good herd leader and your horses know things they can't do, but they don't know that unless you tell them. Everybody's like, my horse pushes me and I know he loves me and I don't want to hit him and I don't want to be mean to him and I don't want to yell. Well, and that's why he does it. See, I don't have to yell at him or hit him or do any of that because they know I will, because I don't nag them and I'm not inconsistent. I don't push them and only make them listen when I'm in a bad mood. I don't let them get away with stuff because I'm in a good mood. That's where a lot of problems come with horses. They just they do better when they have a good, strong leader and they know and they don't have to guess. Ransom does good with Buddy because Buddy knows, hey, he knows I'm in charge, I'm consistent, and sometimes I think he goes overboard, but I'm not a horse, so I'll defer to what Mr. T taught him. So it's about, they said it's going to get 78 today, man. It was 78 yesterday, and the freaking wasp just all sprung out thinking summer's here, and they were everywhere. And so I wish I could find out where they hide in the winter. So there's been no pushing or claiming when I'm standing in between them. There's a thing that's called threshold, and we use it when we're training dogs. And to get a dog's threshold on how far he could find. Oh, they both saw something and I didn't see anything. Isn't that amazing? I'm looking the same way they're eating and they both looked up. And I cannot see a thing that made them do that. So now I'm looking where they were doing it. But I was talking about threshold, for like a dog's threshold. Some dogs better than others. You know, you put two dogs on the same scent cone and one dog will hit it a little bit farther. They must be hearing something because I can't see anything. Not smelling anything. How do I know that? Because the wind's behind them. So they're not smelling where they're looking. If they look behind them, then I would know they were smelling something. But because they're looking forward, they're either seeing it or hearing it. And both times they looked up, I didn't see anything. her little hawk out here. I don't know what it is, but when it comes winter, man, the hawks just seem to be, I can see them. Maybe it's because the trees are bare. Man, I've been seeing so many red-tailed hawks around here. It's just really cool. They're hunting and snagging some mice out of the fields. Maybe they come here because as the grass dies, it's easier to find the mice. But it just seems like lately, man. Yep, there's definitely a hawk over here. See the peaceful harmony of eating when I'm in the middle? So my guess is if I fed them for a week and I stayed out here every time, they would learn to eat together. Usually got things going on. Couldn't tell. I want to find that little hawk. Oh, there's it. That's the one I see. Tell you what. Oh, there's another one underneath him. I don't know if you guys can see him. There's two out there. I forgot what I was talking about. Oh, it's 78. The wind's blowing right now. It's kind of nippy. I have short sleeve shirt on. I'm thinking, man, it'll be that cold out there. It's a little bit nippy. About 8:30 in the morning. Kyle Rittenhouse trial is about to go. The jury's about to go back into deliberations. This will be their second full day. And I'm thinking they're going to come back today or tomorrow. But my guess would be later on this afternoon, or they'll work late. If they work late, we know they're close. But for those that ain't following it, they don't know what I'm talking about. So I'll stop talking about it. So hopefully my body is blocking the wind. Look how nice they eat together. See if I was like trying to trick people and promote how good I am, I would just film like in between it, and I wouldn't explain why it's working and why when I walk away it doesn't work, and I could just like be like, I don't know, I'm not saying Krause, that dude is lying, Clinton or whatever, but when you can cut videos and just show good or just show bad, you know, Lester gets a lot of shit for just showing bad on Carl escaped. It was pretty funny. I was gonna do a video on that and get Carl and show them what I want him to do, or not that I want him to do it. I mean, I'd like to see him do it, because to me, I can have him. It's like anybody that wants other people to do things with horses. They don't want to get out there and do it, but they want someone else to do it, or they'll tell somebody how good they are. So I want to have Lester be my guinea pig and go out there. But I just think my theories will work if they're applied, and I'd like to see them if they're worked. So I know if my theories are based on good, you know, prior education and experience, or if it's, I need to modify what I'm thinking and maybe it doesn't work. But as soon as the wind slows down, it's supposed to get down to 30 tomorrow night. So today is going to be 78. Tomorrow night is going to be 30. That's how Mother Nature messes with these poor horses. They try to grow their little fur, and then they tell you can tell their little fur is like flapping. I don't know if you guys can see that from the wind. Ransom got more fur because he's flapping more. Their little manes are. Nice coffee cup. But Horsy's having my coffee. They're having their little morning coffee. That's what their little hay is in the morning. It's like a little coffee. Tastes good. Gives them a little energy. Again, if you had a salad every day, if people look at their pastures, a salad. So if you had a salad every day made of iceberg lettuce only, and then every once in a while, you'd get a salad with a little, whatever you like in your salad, cucumber, tomato, carrots, whatever. And you get romaine lettuce, maybe a little cabbage, maybe a little, you know, just a nice mixed salad. That's kind of what happens when you give your horses good hay that's fertilized. It just tastes better and it makes them feel good. Look how close they are. Why can't you guys get along like that all the time? Now you notice when Buddy kind of coughed and sneezed, it was almost like still eating. Because remember, horses can't breathe through their mouth. Only breathe through their nose. So I don't know how long. Let's see. I've been here for, what, 12 minutes? That's not too bad. So it took them 12 minutes to share one bale of hay. It's pretty much gone. Again, if I stood out here every time I fed them, the pushiness would stop. If I fed them every day because I was in a hurry and I didn't have time and I just threw it out here and I didn't make two piles, that's how you make aggressive horses. That's how you make horses that fight. That's how you make horses that are food possessive. People always want to come to, my horse is food possessive, my horse. They tell me all these problems the horses have and I'm like, you caused it. No, Rick, I sent it to a trainer and it came from this place. And they want to blame someone else. It doesn't matter. I mean, these two horses, you can modify their behavior by what you do. Now, that's not a hawk. That's a vulture. And he must be on the scent. Because they always kind of work in on the scent that way. So he's quartering just like horses and stuff do. I sure hope he's on screen because I can't see him on screen. It just blues out. And he blends in. So, Loki was in there this morning saying hello, but he didn't want to come out, I guess. Stewie didn't show up for like an hour, 2 hours late yesterday. I was kind of starting to get worried with him because I kept checking on his food, and I was like, uh-oh, he hasn't came and had a snack, so I wonder if something got him. And then a couple hours later, he's over there eating. I'm like, you little survivor, you. So they're almost finished. There's a little, they've eaten all the good stuff and now they're eating stems. That's another clue that you're probably feeding your horses too much. If you're feeding your horses and they're leaving the stems of alfalfa and they walk away, you're feeding them too much. If they're hungry, they're going to eat everything. And the stems are good, of course, it cleans them out. And it's good roughage for them. So you want them to eat that. If they're leaving that, I mean, the stems still have that, you know, nutrition. It's been fertilized. Good nutrients. Kind of like peeling an apple. You lose a lot of nutrients because you don't eat the peelings. Well, look at the stems as the peelings. They may not like it, but if they're not eating it, you're probably feeding them too much. They're not, I mean, hell, I think I feed my guys too much. They only get like one flake a day. Maybe if I know it's going to be cold, I'll put another one out at night. And that's one flake between the two of them. But granted, they've got all this, you know, iceberg lettuce they can snack on all day. He pushed and he got pushed out. Now Ransom gets to sit there and eat. Last come back in. He cause problems.
Rick, that was mean, and you're gonna make him scared of you.
You saw where he loved me when I opened that gate, and he ran. You saw how much he loved me. I think I got a video. Is it better for your horse to love you or respect you? Is it better for your kids to love you or respect you? You can't keep them safe. You can't teach them anything. They may love you. You're going to raise a freaking whiny, entitled, ignorant person that thinks everybody owes them everything. They can always run to their loving parent, even when they're a brat or lying or cheating or stealing. Yeah, okay. See how that works out?
Rick, why are you in a bad mood?
Shut up, you freaking crap. Somebody came here the other day on my gun channel. Said, I hope Rick's not in a bad mood. That person got blocked. That was their last comment. Yep, I'm just not in a mood. Those horsey witches are all right. From their mouth. See if he pushes Ransom off. See how the dynamic changes here. And there he goes. See, I think he just tripped there, and Ransom didn't run. Yeah, I'm still watching, boy. Uh-huh. I'll come back and get in your butt. I'm still mad at you for running away. That's why I'm doing that. That's what I hear. You bucked me off. That's because you bucked me off last week. That's because you tried to kick me 2 days ago. That's stupid. I ain't mad at him because he ran off. I ain't doing this to be vindictive and mean. Doing it to keep structure. All right, so I'll get a little further. Let's see how long it takes for Buddy to go. Right there. So this is his threshold. I was talking about threshold. I'm at the gate. This is how far I had to get before Buddy felt he could do that without getting correction from me. Now see, I can't reach out and touch him, and he knows that. This is when, if I wanted to get his attention, if I wanted to, I could pick up a rock, a slingshot, anything, and reach out and touch him in the butt and sting him when I go, no! And he'd like, holy crap, he can touch me from that far away. I gotta listen to him when he's further. That's why you want to increase your dog's threshold on when you can call him out. When we send a dog to attack, we would tell him to stop. And some dogs were stop if at 5 feet, but if you let them go 6 feet, they weren't coming back. Some dogs would stop at 10 feet, but if you let them go 12, 15 feet, they weren't coming back. So every dog had a different threshold, and you wanted to always try and increase that threshold to where you had control of your dog at a further distance. Same way with horses. If you only can correct your horse when you're in arm's reach, that's your threshold for correction. And your horse knows that. So therefore he knows he doesn't have to listen to you at arm's reach. So therefore, when you're running around a barn,
Charlie! Muffin, you better stop that. A cupcake, I'm gonna get, you need.
It doesn't matter. All that does is put freaking ear pain on everyone else around you, because your horse doesn't care. He knows you can't do anything, you're just nagging, so you teach him to ignore your correction, to ignore your voice, because you're nagging when you can't follow up with a correction. And until you increase that threshold, of the horse thinks you can touch him and actually correct him. And that's why a lot of people say shock collars are good, because you don't have to be close. The problem with shock collars is the people using them. If shock collars were used correctly, you would rarely have to use it. You'd use it once, maybe twice, and you wouldn't have to use it again. The threat of using it would be the thing. The problem is most people use it, they don't know how to use it, they cheat, they're inconsistent. They do it because they're mad. They do it because they're angry. They do it for different reasons. And you know what? The animal just learns to take it, learned helplessness. He ignores it, and it doesn't work. And then they'll be sending me an email.
I tried a shock collar and it didn't work. And everybody said it would work. And I tried clicker training and I tried to do what you did and it didn't work. And you don't know what you're talking.
All right, whatever. Crazy people. I pretty much figured out you can't help crazy. All right, I don't see Stewie. You can tell I didn't feed Stewie yet. People be like, oh, you're being mean. I just fed the horses. Where's that crazy cat at? He was up there eating. I didn't give him his little treat either, so he's probably pissed at me too. I must piss him off everybody today. Let's see if this little thing dried. Painted up this little thing. It was all rusty and stuff, so I put that rust converter on it. Yeah, it turned out okay. Now I gotta try and re-weld that little chain there. So this little chain right here is supposed to be like right here for the third chain. So, I wonder how long that'll last through the winter, cut it or whatever. Man, I gotta do something on this mold. It's really bugging me every time I come back here. Somebody said, somebody put a comment to kill the little bushes in my stuff over here to use bleach and something. I can't use bleach because this is that rubber and it's dyed rubber. It's not wood chips. And if I use bleach, it'll bleach off the color. The color's good for 10 years. I'm pretty sure that that's going to void if I come out here and spray bleach on it, trying to kill it. Well, Stewie's not back there either. I don't know where that crazy rabbit hides, man. He's a good little hider. Oh, there comes a hawk. Here, let me set my coffee down without spilling it. See if I can't zoom in on him. Shit, where'd he go? He must have turned. Unless he swooped down and got him a mouse. Yep, I lost him. All right. I haven't checked our water this morning. Make sure there's no big critters in it every morning. I've only found a dead critter in there. Maybe, oh, there's a little pigeon. That's why he was hiding from the freaking hawk. So he was in my tree hiding from the hawk. Or I said pigeon, it's probably a dove. Hopefully I didn't get that little dove killed by chasing him out of the tree. That hawk's hanging around looking for a meal. Poor little Belle, always coming over crying for food. They don't feed their horses. It just irritates me to death. You don't want your horse showing ribs going into winter. Very bad. It's hard enough just to keep weight on them in the winter. Worse when they go into the winter skinny. Now they can't catch up. They're just trying to survive. And they don't have a good coat or a good fat base or good hair. All right. That's a little Ransom's butt. He's got a good little fat coat for sure. Good boys.